So let's talk about what happens when our estimates change. In this problem, in this example, we're going to look at the same Papa Company example that we were before, but this time something's going to happen in year four, or the January 1st of the fourth year. So we're going to have to do some recalculations. So let's see how this goes. First and foremost, we get the copy machine. It's still going to be 16,000. That doesn't change. So equipment, copy machine, 16,000. That's just getting it in to our facility, putting in our books at TAC. Then we need to go through the depreciation calculations. That's not going to change. Total asset cost minus salvage value all over useful life is going to give us 24,000 or 2,400. Still going to be the same. Year one is going to be the same. So journal entry is going to be the same. Year two is going to be the same. Again, journal entry is going to be the same. Year three, so on and so forth. And then we get to year four. And it says in the second paragraph, it says, on January 1st of the fourth year, Papa Company determines that the copy machine's useful life increased to 9 years. Originally it was five, but then all of a sudden in the fourth year, we realized, you know what, we're going to keep it a little bit longer. We're going to keep it for an additional 4 years. So at that moment, we need to recalculate. Now, we're not going to go back and fix everything in the past. We're just going to start from this moment forward. So we need to do the recalculation for the fourth year. So what we're going to start with is TAC, always where we start with. But remember, this is only going to impact what we have not depreciated yet. So we have to take out what we have already depreciated, which is our accumulated depreciation. So TAC minus accumulated depreciation minus the salvage value. And then we're going to divide that all over the remaining useful life, whatever the useful life we have left that we haven't depreciated yet. So our TAC is still 16,000. Now this is January 1st of the fourth year, so that means we have to use the third year's information. So our third year's accumulated depreciation is 7,200, so that's our accumulated depreciation. Our salvage value is still the same, still 4,000. And then our remaining useful life. So currently it sits now at an increase to 9 years, so 9 years is where we start, but we've already done 3 years. This is year one, year two, year three in our table. So we gotta take away 3 years. That means that we're gonna depreciate this over the remaining 6 years. And that's going to give us $800 per year. Now on our table, we need to extend this a little bit more because we don't have just 5 years, we have 9 years. So we're going to add the other 4 years on there and continue going. So year four, we're going to have a depreciation expense of 800 and then add 800 to the 7,200 that's already existing in there. That gives us 8,000 as our accumulated depreciation balance. Our journal entry is still going to be depreciation expense and accumulated depreciation, but this time it's going to be 800 because of the new calculation. And we're going to do this from year 5 through 9 as well. It's going to be the same thing. So again, depreciation expense, 800, accumulated depreciation, 800 for the next 4 years, or excuse me, 5 years. So if we put that and we finish out on our table, year 5 through 9, 800 straight down the board. And if we continue adding 800 to what's already in accumulated depreciation, 8,800, 9,600, 10,400, 11,200, and then finally 12,000, which should ring a bell, because if we were to look at our depreciable base, even with the new adjustments, our depreciable base, our TAC is still 16,000. Our salvage value is still 4,000. So that means our depreciable base is still 12,000. So we've hit that number as well. Now that's how you recalculate it if the useful life is changed. What happens if the salvage value is changed as well? So let's look at another example for that. Same thing, we're back at Papa Company, same intro to it, but this time it says on January 1st, the fourth year, Papa Company determined that the copy machine's useful life had increased to 9 years and the salvage value decreased to 1600. So both the useful life and the salvage value has changed now. So everything up to this point is still the same because again, nothing has changed until the fourth year. So now we're in our fourth year, we need to do the recalculation again. So again, it is TAC minus salvage or TAC minus accumulated depreciation minus the salvage value, the new salvage value, all over the remaining useful life. So again, TAC is 16,000. Accumulated depreciation is 7,200, because that's what we have in our third year. And then our salvage value, this time now we're going to use the new one, which is 1,600. The new useful life is 9. We've already done 3 years, so we need to take out those 3. That's going to leave us with 6. So if we do the calculations, that's going to give us a depreciation expense of 1,200 per year. So again, we need to add 4 more years. Year 4, it's going to be 1,200. Add that to the existing accumulated depreciation, 8,400. Our journal entry is going to still look the same, but this time it's going to be 1,200 with the new calculation. And again, we're going to do this years five through nine. So again, depreciation expense, $1,200, accumulated depreciation for each year, five through nine. If we filled out our table, years five through nine are going to be $1,200 into depreciation expense. And then our accumulated depreciation, we're going to add $1,200 to it. This time, however, you will see that our ending accumulated depreciation is $14,400. Does that make sense? Well, let's check. Let's check our depreciable base. Our TAC is $1,600. Our new salvage value is $1,600. So that gives me a depreciable base of $14,400. So yes, we're exactly where we need to be. So that's how you do an example of a change in useful life and a change in salvage value. Hopefully that made sense. If you have any questions, let us know. Y'all have a good one.